Booyah. Can you hear me now? Can you hear me now? All right. So, it was so much fun. I was having so much fun and you weren't even there. You missed it. Unless you're a really good lip reader. So, let me start over this real quick. And thank you for posting up that you were missing the sound. But sounds here, and it's my fault. Using a different computer today, we're going to talk about why can't you have cheese on a cart? Well, some places you can, and sometimes there's workarounds, loopholes. I like loopholes, right? I think our federal government created those for rich people. Anyway, so here's the deal. When I was vending, let me read the question first. I'm going to read the question because it just makes sense. Here's the question. This is from Eric. And the question is, okay, Ben, here's an item I have heard vendors say they can't sell on their cart. I talked to my health inspector and asked him about cheese on the cart, and he said no, with an exclamation mark. But I asked him if I could use Velveeta cheese and melt it down in my commissary and use it as a condiment. Okay? Fill up condiment containers, keeping it in the steam table and dispensing it on Philly cheesesteaks and chili cheese dogs or nachos. Just a thought. Haven't heard an answer yet. Now, let me answer this in multiple ways. Okay? Let me go back to my little screen here so I can see everybody. Okay, so let me go back a little bit. If you go to learnhotdogs.com and click on the free training, I go through this in my story of what happened, but I'm going to cut to the chase and give you that real quick. When I started vending, I wanted cheese. I wanted just sprinkle cheese, a little shredded cheese because people like chili cheese dogs, right? So I was like, okay, I'm going to do chili cheese dogs, and this is going to be great. And thank y'all for being here. I appreciate it. And I'm going to get to your questions and all that stuff here in a minute. But I want to go through Eric's thing real quick, and you may run into this yourself. So, and I'm going to also teach you about some loopholes. So I said to my inspector, can I have cheese? He said, no, you can't have cheese. And so I got to thinking, I being from pretty much white trash, and growing up most of my life in a trailer park, I had Cheese Whiz. And if you don't know what Cheese Whiz is, it is fantastic, and they even made it better now. They got different flavors and jalapeno bacon Cheese Whiz. And what it does, it comes in a can, it's like an aerosol can. You just squeeze the end, and it comes out like caulk, okay? Kind of tastes like caulk, similar to caulk. And so what you do with the Cheese Whiz, or what it's made of, is it is 1% cheese, 99% whiz. And so you take that Cheese Whiz and you squirt it on the hot dog, and people love it. People freaking love it. Okay, at least in my area, they love it. Now, some areas, probably they're probably going to look at you funny, you squirting out cheese out of a can. But, hey. So I asked my inspector, he said, absolutely, you can use that because it's not a cheese product. Well, actually, it says right on the can cheese product, but I'm not going to argue with him, right? He gave me permission. So I went to, then later, got a new inspector. That new inspector, I said, hey, can I do cheese? Oh, sure, you can do shredded cheese stuff, but don't do cheese sauce. Well, why can't I do cheese sauce? Oh, we just don't allow it. Okay. I didn't know at the time you have to ask for proof. You know, you don't just say, hey, give me proof. Like all cocky, you use diplomacy. Okay. And you say, where can I find that in the code? Now, sometimes you'll find it in the code. Like in Tennessee, you will find that in the code. You can't serve cheese, okay? But you can serve these products of cheese products. So it's kind of like mincing words, because cheese slices is natural, is 100% natural cheese, but it's called a cheese product. So I don't know how all that works, but the bottom line is, usually you can get a workaround with your health inspector. Okay, now Eric was talking about putting it in the little, they're called portion control cups, okay? And they're little clear, you ever gone to a place and they go, hey, you want your jalapenos on the side? Well, sure I do. Or my sour cream on the side? Absolutely. And they'll take a little clear plastic container, put a lid on it, put over whatever you wanted inside of it, and now you've got it on the side. Well, I was allowed to do cheese sauce on the side. I had to fill it at the commissary, okay? And then I could keep those hot, the cheese sauce, hot, because I like to walk in tacos and that kind of stuff that sold good. And I would keep them in the steam table. Now, you can use styrofoam containers as well, but the plastic containers work great. You put down a restaurant cloth down in the bottom of your steam table, and then you set those in there to stay hot all day. It's excellent. So, and then you can change them out. Like as you move some out, you put another couple rows of the colder ones from your cooler in there. And by the time you get to them, they're good and hot. So it's really simple to do. But cheese isn't the only thing. My health inspector said, no freaking onions. Okay? No onions. Why can't I use onions? And I get these questions all day long. I'm talking while I was prepping for this show earlier. I get this is a member in our group. And let's see if this says it here.
So did you ever have a problem with your Coke onions, per se, doing them on the cart? Was that up to an inspector too? Like if one walked up on you?
So my Vendors United, we use WhatsApp and we communicate all day long. Well, that was one of the Vendors United members, and he's wanting to know what he can kind of get away with. He's got this thing coming up, and he's wanting to make sure he uses the right stuff. And what do you think he should approach the health inspector with? And so there are some loopholes, and usually if you'll go, hey, is there a way that I can prep this or prepare it so that I can serve it on the cart? They'll typically create a workaround for you. Now, I wasn't allowed to do onions at all. Then the new inspector came in and said, oh yeah, you can do onions, but no raw onions, just cooked onions. What? Raw onions? No. Cooked onions, yes. Raw onions I can sell from the back of a pickup truck on the side of the road, but can't serve them from my hot dog cart. That's correct. Sometimes you can't even make logical sense out of it. It's just like they pull the stuff out of thin air. They're like, oh, I'm going to grab this over here, and you can't do this. And so, anyway, Kevin, they broke. My glasses broke. This is my backup pair. They look like 1940s, and they're pretty light, but they're big. Big. I told my wife, I said, they feel ridiculous on my face, but I broke my other ones. I was moving bees, and I'm a little beekeeper, and so, hence the shirt. And so, anyway, I was moving bees today and broke my glasses. Anyway. So there's typically a workaround. So sometimes they'll let you do your sour cream. I wanted to do sour cream, okay? Because Coke onions go great with sour cream, and I snuck it in either way. I snuck it into it, cooked it into it right at the end of my Coke onions. Well, later I asked them, is there a way I can serve that? Yes, if you get a professional cream cheese gun, okay, not sour cream, cream cheese. If you get a professional cream cheese gun, it's this big caulk gun, a literal caulk gun, and it comes with these huge containers you pack full of cream cheese, and you squirt the cream cheese out, okay? And I squirted on top of the dogs. And they allowed that as long as I kept the gun in the cooler and only pulled it out to use. It was ideal. Now, some vendors don't even have to keep it in their cooler, and they actually, like we did a video and everything, but he kept cream cheese gun on his side like a gun in a holster, and he'd pull it out and do your cream cheese across the top. So some foods are really good with it, and some types of wild meats from a cart. Like we've got vendors who do like alligator, crocodile, buffalo, all kinds of stuff. That they do wild game meats from their cart. They specialize in wild game. You might have heard Jason Brown talking about his. He does it occasionally from his food truck, and it's just fantastic. So the bottom line is you kind of have to find out, ask them, and then say, is there a way to do it? I know you don't allow it this way, but is there a way to do it? Well, if the customer serves it themselves, you'll literally get these. You'll get these things that are not considered safe to serve from an open cart, but because you brought it in individual servings, you can. Like I couldn't do mayonnaise, and we get a lot of requests for mayonnaise. People love it on a chili cheese dog. I love it on a chili cheese dog. So I could keep it in the packets. Mayonnaise in this little single packs, you just rip them open, right? And those don't have to be refrigerated at all. And they're good for like 300 years. So don't know how that works either, but it says real mayonnaise from Hellman's. I had Hellman's packs. Kraft makes them too. So you can do this several different ways you want. Eric, I just answered your question. I hope that answered all of it. I hope that, like, gave you enough information so that you're dangerous and that you can speak to the health inspector and maybe get offered some opportunities for some other stuff. You did right by asking about doing those containers. You don't even have to use Velveeta down. Velveeta gets, when it gets cold, it coagulates quick. It's hard to keep Velveeta smooth. And so I would go with a cheese sauce. I buy it in number 10 cans. Number 10 cans is like restaurant cans, okay? And you can keep that hot. Your health inspector may even let you buy it in the bags. They make these big 1 gallon size or 2 gallon size bags of nacho cheese sauce. Keep it in your steam table, pull it out. It's got a handle and it's got a valve, okay? And you can drench your food in it. It's delicious and it's really heart healthy. So there's that. Okay, so I apologize for no sound at the beginning. Let me go through this real quick and make sure I didn't. Oh, I had another thing I wanted to go through too, but I don't know if y'all saw, and I'd love for y'all to give her some support in the comments. I don't know which video it was. I may can find it in a second. Remember, we had a 14-year-old boy looking to do vending. We have a 15-year-old girl has already started vending. Okay, so there's... You never know who you're going to encourage and inspire, and I freaking love it. I love it. I love that these kids are, you know, off the couch, quitting playing, you know, Nintendo or whatever they're playing, PlayStation and Xbox, and they're actually learning skills that they can use in life forever. Things that you could lose your job as a... We had a chiropractor lost his office, okay? He lost his business in 2008. He came over and bought a cart from me. We talked for hours. Nice guy, but very college grad, you know, PhD type person. And so I had to look up some of his words in a dictionary. But bottom line is he ended up getting a cart. He never went back to chiropractic and now has 2 or 3 carts in the Charlotte, Mecklenburg County area of North Carolina. It's because what I was getting at is it's a great fallback. If you enjoy doing something else, I'd never tell you, jump ship, come over here, the grass is greener. No, it's still work, it's still hard. But, wouldn't it be nice, your truck driving job, get laid off, or your wife's fixing to leave you, or your husband's fixing to leave you because you're on the road all the time, or whatever it is, that you can go do something like this. We have retirees doing this to supplement their income. We have kids doing it. We have, the whole range is huge. It's such a neat business. And you can tell I'm a little biased, just barely. Okay, let's see. There's a bunch of comments, and I'm going to try to get through some of them. Not all of them. I don't think I'll make it because we have a show at 9, our Vendors United group. If you aren't in Vendor, try Vendors United. If you have $27, try Vendors United for a month. I promise you, you're going to go, oh my gosh, what we do in there. How much everybody helps everybody. It's like hot dog church, except there ain't a preacher. Everybody comes out, new people may have, oh, I have a marketing degree and I'm doing hot dogs. I can help you with your Facebook ad. You wouldn't believe the freaking power of information in the group. If you want to know more about that, learnhotdogs.com/join. I've got a little video there. You can watch it and see if it's worth the while. There's no contract. There's no obligation. Try it for a month and then cancel if you don't like it. Okay? Okay, got sound. Howdy, city dogs. Okay, Michael's here. Twisted Birch is here. Rich Eubanks. Michael Dugan. Random Brandon. Always a tongue twister for me. Random Brandon. Pittsburgh Steel Mills. Ben, my health department, said I can't use a pop-up tent because everything has to be confined to the cart. Your pop-up tent has to be confined to the cart. I do have a suggestion for you. Ask to see it in code. I have an article I want you to look up, okay, as soon as I hang up here. Learnhotdogs.com/liar. Nothing to buy there, okay? I'm not selling nothing. I want you to read that. Learnhotdogs.com/liar. It's the way to approach and get suss out the truth from these people that are... A lot of times, they're human beings like us. They put on their pants one leg at a time, just like you and I do, right? And they they get power hungry, some of them, okay? Their egos get ahead of them, and they just create stuff, and most people don't question it. They go, oh, that's the health inspector. They said it, so it's got to be true. I have literally on the... Y'all have heard me do this. I've literally on the phone asked a health inspector, can you show me the code? Oh, let me find that real quick. It's not really in the code. It's just the way it's always been. Well, can you enforce something that's not in the code? Well, no, we really can't do that. Okay, so I'm good to go with that then, right? Okay. Dang, I didn't get notified of when the video started. I can't have cheese, but the cheese products, I found this powder to make your own cheese sauce made by Velveeta. It tastes freaking great. I have had it. The Top Dog Ricky Jensen. I have had that cheese sauce. It is freaking delicious. I love it. It's great. It's harder. You know, it's another step in your day that you got to mix up this cheese, but good for you for looking for it and finding it. You are a wonderful host, so honest and so committed to the folks who seek your help. The best, Donald Padiga. Thank you very much for the kind words. I love it. Appreciate it. Danny Brown, I love all the smiley faces or smirks with the sunglasses. Ask my inspector about using Velveeta. Yep. You'll get an answer. Rocky Dog's Catering, our good prepackaged slaw out there seems most are too creamy. I like crunchy to my slaw. Rocky Dog's and Catering, email me and I'll give you a recipe if you want to make it yourself. There are some solutions depending on how busy you are. Okay, you can go to Cisco. You can call Cisco and say, I want to try every single slaw that you can get your hands on. They'll send them to you for free. Okay, try them. Now, if you're not doing enough volume to order from Cisco, go to a broadline distributor. So go to Google, type in your town name, put broadline distributor near me, see if you can find a broadline distributor, and then say the same thing to them. You can find slaw, but if you need a recipe for slaw, for the good crunchy slaw, I have one. Okay? It is a pain in the neck. It's something, it's not like hard to make, it's just something else you have to make. Okay? Just something else left to do. And I try to simplify that. But there's another step. We have some vendors that are really, they do a lot of volume, okay? And so they have taken their own recipe, like their chili sauce or their whatever, their slaw, and you can go to a company who will just make it for you, and you say, I want this much of it, and they'll make just this much of it. Now, the more you make, the cheaper it gets, but you get big enough, you can do that as well. We have vendors doing that. David Bogan says, well worth the 27. Thank you, David, for the testimonial there. It's $1,700 unusual for health department fee. Can be, yeah. That's high, okay? And that's almost discriminatory. It's discriminately high. They'd have to apply that fee all the way across the board. Restaurants, everybody doing it, okay? Sally's lemonade stand, if she has to be inspected, $1,700, Sally. It has to be even Stevens, right? Don't even know who Steven is, but that's how we compare evens. So, anyway, if you take the, I would double check. I'd find out if that's truly the fee. It sounds high. I've heard of some high fees, like in Washington State, King County, $550. $550, which I went, what? Stupid. There's places in California that $350, $400, not $550. $1,700 blows my mind. I'd go hit Hot Dog Church, Reverend Ben Wilson. Thank you, Randy Brandon. Greetings from Mad Jackie Street Catering. Mad Jackie's in the house. Dave Berg, thanks for being here. Ron, I've been slinging 2 weeks now and haven't made enough to get by on. Ron, then there's a problem, okay? And you're not alone, okay? We had a lady, listen to this real quick. We had a lady in our Vendors United group. She's brand new at vending, been struggling for about a month. She finally comes and tells us. We didn't know she was struggling. She told us in the group on last Monday night. We look at her videos. We look at her pictures. She provided us. We look at everything. And we're all kind of at a loss until a new vendor named Diz, who's been vending now for several months, but he's still fairly new, goes, he calls me after the show on here and goes on WhatsApp and goes, I think it may be this. Well, guess what? It was this one thing, one freaking thing that I just didn't catch it. And it was a brilliant catch, and it's changed. That's how you change things. But I would be happy to help you if you'll share more with me. If you'll send me, you can email me pictures of your cart setup at a distance and up close, everything around your setup, and tell me a little bit about where you're set up, okay? And I'll try to help you the best I can. Ron, I hope you got that. What's up? Thanks for getting back to me about the business proposal. We got turned down, but he says keep in touch. Alex, Lucky Dog will do. Keep it up. Thank you, Alex. Rocky Dog's Catering, good advice. Thanks. I'm reading your book and halfway through it. Oh, my gird. I like that. Oh, my gird. I remember those memes. So much fun and helpful book. Twisted Birch, thank you very much. If you're interested in the book, learnhotdogs.com/book. That's it. /book. Almost world famous hot dogs and catering, 430 in Alaska. There's another one of those high fees to get started. Danny Brown, Ben is great. Thanks, Danny. You are too. Danny Brown is great. You heard it here. Morgan Crowley, get his book. It's great info. Thank you a bunch. Ron, thanks. You're welcome. Rocky Dog, join VU, y'all. It will save you time and so informative. Absolutely. It'll save you a lot of time. You'll have more help than you know what to do with. Because you got pro vendors and they're just dying to help people and they're doing good and they're still vending every day and they'll go, oh, just call me on the WhatsApp and I'll hook you up. I'll tell you what to do. They typically without the hillbilly accent like me. How do I get plates for my hot dog cart? How do I get plates? Are you talking about license plates, tags? Okay. If that's what you're talking about, all in all hot dogs and catering, here's where I want you to go. I have this. Okay. I have this for you. Let me just find the link for you real quick. Learn Hot Dogs. I'm assuming you probably don't have a title. And that's why you're asking. Because if you had a title, you could go get... you could go get plates, right? You go to your DMV or your tag agency. And I'm trying to find this now. That was somebody that... has a really loud. Okay, you're gonna like this. I'm pulling it up now and I'm gonna share it with you here. Okay. Oh, registered as a homemade trailer. You can. Yes, some people do that. Even if it wasn't, they lost their title. I've given that advice in here before. That's great advice. Okay, here's the link for yours. Hope that helps. That's a good video and everything. According to Wikipedia. So, let's see. On your feet. Time to get the hot dog meat. Dogs on the run. Getting my you're getting your inspection Thursday. Mario, congratulations. Congratulations. Let us know how it goes. Do I need a title for a hot dog cart in Tennessee? No, you do not. No, you do not need a title or tags in Tennessee for a trailer. So you're good to go. I did put a link in there for how to get a title, though. Dustin, thanks for being here. I'm doing great. I get that subject may not be appropriate for this, but sure, I need help getting the right cart now that I have the right Denver County requirements. You are my only hope, Obi Kenobi. Ruth, let me tell you, okay, I want you to do this for me, okay? Guess what my number one question has been for 9 years? Which cart do I need to get for my... So I created the Ben's Top 10 list. It's the top most asked questions I get asked daily. I just put the link into you. Guess what the first one will be? Which cart do I need for my area? And I answer that there for you. And I'll help you further. My contact information's on the site directly. So go there. Check that out. That should help you. I know it will. I know I'm 100% positive that it'll solve your problem. Morgan says he's building me a cash cow. Can't wait to get it. I got tons of Ben's ideas. I will try and use some of my wife's ideas. Absolutely take everybody's ideas. Just... implement them, you know, logically and step by step, so that you don't have a bajillion things going on at once. That's the best way to do that. I need to go, but let me, Mike's Dogs at Home, Kenny Room will be ready to roll. Michael Grosso, this freaking fantastic. I can't wait. Your hot dog inspection is Monday. Can 10-gallon freshwater tank fit in a cash cow cart? Absolutely, it can. It can. 100%. Let's see. I need to do one thing, and then I'm going to go, okay? I need to go over here to the comments, okay? Let me go over to the comments from before. I just want to point this out. Broccoli Heart, thank you for the kind words. I'm just giving you a shout-out. I thank you. Brian Shores commented. If y'all know who Brian Shores was, if you listen to the old podcast, you'd know he's a longtime vendor. Flipped his card over, and we ended up calling him Flipper. He was on here commenting. This is it. This was, can a 14-year-old, remember the thing I did with the funny face? Can a 14-year-old be a vendor? On those comments, go give this person some encouragement. There's a girl on there, Bishmonton Rossi. Says she's a 14-year-old girl. First day was today. That was yesterday. Give them some encouragement. Freaking awesome that we got such good people here. I hope that helps. I hope this helped you, and I hope this helps you understand that there's ways to vend. Let me give you one last thing on vending, on having things on your cart that maybe you can't. If you're doing private stuff, you absolutely can do whatever you want pretty much in every state. You can double check with your health inspector, but pretty much when it's considered catering, all the rules go out the window, and as long as you keep it food safe and you prepped it at a commissary, you can serve what you want because they are buying the food. Okay? Pizza is not considered to be safe. It's considered to be potentially hazardous, just like cheese. Okay? So it's potential, and raw onions, apparently. Those are potentially hazardous foods. But they allow pizza to be delivered. You know why? Because it falls under a catering thing. It doesn't fall of, I'm selling pizza from my hot dog cart. Okay? So keep that in mind. And I hope that helps. And I love you. And I hope you have a awesome, awesome evening. And I'll see all you Vendors United members here in about 29 minutes.